have sitting at home is, hey, should I continue to have my kids drink milk?
Absolutely. I think the concerning thing about this particular study is that it sends a lot of confusing messages to parents. And the short answer to your question is yes, you do need to keep drinking milk because milk is still one of the best sources of calcium. The flip side of the argument, though, is that maybe there are other sources of calcium out there other than just milk. And that's where the study sheds a little bit of light.
Not everyone agrees with this study. We got a response from the National Dairy Council earlier today. We're going to put it up on the screen for the folks at home so that you can see it with us. But basically called this, it's a review paper, which is going to be appearing in the journal Pediatrics. And the Dairy Council saying here, consensus in the scientific and medical community is strong regarding the value of dairy foods in a healthy diet, which you just said to us. The positive role in milk and milk products in the diet has been established through numerous clinical trials, which are considered the gold standard for evaluating cause and effect relationships. Do you agree with the Dairy Council statement?
I agree with them. Partly. Mm-hmm. I do still think dairy products are an important source of calcium. Let me give you an example. We set a recommendation a few years ago that the calcium requirement needs to be between 800 milligrams and 1500 milligrams per day for children and adolescents. Even though those requirements were set, most people don't reach that level. Most kids aren't reaching that level. They're reaching close to maybe 700, but they're not really even getting close to that point. So if we now say you don't need that much and start cutting back, the concern is we won't even get close to the amount we need. So I still think calcium or dairy products are an excellent source of calcium, and we need to stick with that, but we need to look at other food sources as well. One of our biggest problems, I think, in this country is that we stick to one food source and keep thinking that's the answer for everything,
right.
And whereas that's not necessarily the case.
So what are some of the other foods that are good sources of calcium?
Well, one thing that this particular study looked at, they looked at dark green leafy vegetables. For example, one cup of dark green leafy vegetables like kale or collard greens is equivalent to a cup of cow's milk. Mm. Now, I know it's hard to get your children to eat that. A cup of broccoli also is a good source of calcium. Fortified orange juice, even soy milk, those are all excellent sources of calcium.
The study also, or the review paper rather, also recommended weight-bearing exercise. Does this mean young kids are supposed to be lifting weights? That seems a little dangerous.
Well, let's clarify young kids, okay? What the study looked at was kids between the ages of 12 and 18 years of age. For those children, when they participated in weight-bearing exercises, they absolutely had a better bone mineral density than those who did not. So what my recommendation would be to one of my patients would be that, yes, your children in that age group should be participating in weight-bearing exercises like lifting weights with proper supervision, but I don't think a four-year-old is ready yet to be out there pumping iron quite yet.
All right, well, thanks for clearing up. So bottom line, exercise is good, along with varying where you get your calcium, and you can keep drinking
exactly.
Milk. Dr. Tasmin Hawk, thanks for clearing it up.
You're welcome.